Well, I'm delighted to be joined for this 10 by 10 session by Mark Hewitt, someone who worked with for a number of years. But Mark, why don't you start by maybe telling us a little bit about your background and how you've got into the wonderful world of XR?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, Casper. Well, my background is actually quite diverse. I got into predominantly connected packaging about 8-9 years ago. The background I have is predominantly data, it's digital, it's working within agencies, it's working within marketing teams, within predominantly CPGs. And I guess AR, XR, VR, I've come across over those last 8 years predominantly from a connected pack perspective. And for me, it's been fascinating because the creativity required to hold attention when you have seconds with products in hand is something that is the thing one has to noodle. If you're a marketeer, if you're a brand owner, that's the thing to think about. And I think, you know, this discussion around XR, AR, VR is critical to understanding how one retains memorability and importantly, differentiation.
Absolutely. And I think, you know, you have been looking at this specifically in the realm of sort of CPGs for a number of years and frankly, quite ahead of its time for a while. What are the sort of lessons that you've observed, in AR? I mean, you talked about that sort of piece of storytelling, but what are the other things that I guess you've seen that have either been, you know, sort of aha moments or moments in time that have opened up the opportunity, I guess, in this market?
Yeah, exactly. And you're going to smile, Casper, because, you know, there's been a few moments the last few years. The first thing is obviously when you get to, you know, the world of AR, particularly within the world of packaging and products, it's always about scale. Every big CPG has a set it and scale it mentality. And when you get into the world of AR, one, that becomes a very costly exercise. So I think, you know, the things that have changed over the years is understanding how you go on a learning journey and how AR fits into that learning journey. The other big thing is, as you will know, the world of QR and QR codes and web AR has massively transformed the ability for people to access AR, not via apps, which I know for CPGs in particular has been a big deal. And then the other thing that often makes me smile, and I know it does you, Casper, as well, is context. You know, the context and understanding of when people are going to scan something and when that scan, first of all, is something that's going to be valuable for people to scan, so they'll actually do it. And secondly, the promise that one has set up is actually delivered when they scan. And I think that over the years, many brands have not quite got that right. But I think the last few years, it's starting to see many brands across quite a few categories, actually, not just, you know, in the world of CPG, but in terms of beauty, in terms of food and drink, in terms of hygiene, have all started to look at an understanding of why somebody would scan. What's the value to them? And I think AR's got a really big role to play in this area.
And you talk about that scale piece. You know, how easy is it for the big corporates and sort of brands and organizations that you've been working with? How easy is it for them to do that, just in terms of the way they're set up for you know, taking on a camera capability?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you'll know this better than me, Casper, but I've seen in the past the world of AR has sat in innovation teams. And those innovation teams have then done, let's call them, you know, MVPs or test projects, and they are costed and set up in silos. They're actually quite expensive, as you will know, as one-offs, and expensive not because of the technology, but more of just how the infrastructure to buy them within, you know, brands is set up. And I think that, you know, I think the next few years we'll start to see brands looking at this not within innovation teams, but as actual live relevant opportunities, particularly because we're in a world of contactlessness and obviously COVID has brought us all of that. I think, you know, more and more brands will be looking at the mobile ability for people to scan and get value. And I think brands then need to start thinking about, and they are already, how can they get the benefit of the assets over time, almost as platform plays rather than creative plays. And I think that's the thing that starts to make this, one, a very cost-efficient and high-performing area for brands. And secondly, I think the other thing in this, which you'll know as well, is measurement. You know, this is an area, particularly when you're talking about packaging that is part of a customer journey, it's not really measured in ways that other media is really, really massively measured. And I think the media agencies have got something here to contribute, to come to the party and start looking and understanding these moments in times when one has the product and one is looking to differentiate oneself within that situation. So I think then the scalability of this and the performance of this start to really add up for brands, which I think in the past haven't done so far.
I think that's what's been so interesting about, you know, having your insights from your past experience into the world of XR, of really interrogating the data and the measurement of it. And, you know, what are the sorts of metrics that you're seeing that come out of these kinds of engagements that kind of excite you about the potential?
Yeah. And I think, well, there's four ones, really, four main ones. One is obviously, you know, the scan rate, and the scan rate being, you know, what's the value exchange that makes this exciting and relevant, someone's life easier, simpler, what's the reason to scan? So that's the first thing. The second thing is then the dwell times. Once they get to these landing platforms, how long do people spend there? What do they explore? What do they engage with? And as I say, this is where AR, XR really has an opportunity to provide major amount of value compared to other media. Then I think there's return rates, which will also give an understanding of, you know, is this something people remember, want to come back to? And then the fourth thing in this is to link it with sales. Super difficult, actually, in big organizations that are complex and fragmented. But those four elements are the four elements that really start to deliver an understanding of the value that these types of activities can give, not just binary sales and not just binary scans, but really the engagement opportunity, which starts to link to things like brand power, starts to link to things like, you know, subscription and loyalty, all those sorts of things.
Yeah, it definitely feels like it's an exciting time now, and that almost we have got to a critical mass of enough businesses really taking this seriously. Are there any things then specifically that make you excited about this next period? Because, you know, it's been one of these conversations that's always been, we're almost there, but do you sort of, you know, get excited about this next 2-3 years?
Yeah, I do, because one, you, I, and a few of us in this ecosystem have been doing this for many years, sort of repeating the same sort of value and sales pitch. The truth of the matter is that COVID has massively accelerated, you know, people's ability and understanding of why they would scan. I think that the media value of mobile rather than just digital has become now a driving growth opportunity. And I think what excites me most is that, you know, if we can find ways to commercially scale this within businesses, and I think all these businesses that in the past looked at this as innovation, and I think now starts to see this as a way to engage on an ongoing basis with people who are more mobile than ever before, then I think one starts to will really start to see lots of different variations on how this can be used, from purely pragmatic, informational led type activities through to the inspirational brand storytelling that, is almost TV ad-esque. I think when you start to then, you know, integrate this into social, when you start to think about what subscription, repurchase, loyalty looks like, different than before, then I really get excited to say, you know, that we're only at the starting line in the world of AR and XR. And really, you know, this untapped area within the consumer journey, when you are using the product, is something that I think will become, at scale, something of real media value as well as consumer value, because I think people want to know what's in the products that they're buying. And just to add, I mean, sustainability and purpose as one of the key use cases is just a driving force for this as well. That's not going to go away. So people understanding how they can get involved with initiatives, understanding where the ingredients come from, understanding, is this a brand that has a philosophy that links with mine about being kinder to the planet, are all things that people that, you know, that want to know. They're going to influence purchase and they're going to influence repurchase as well.
Fantastic. Unbelievably, our 10 minutes are already up. I could talk about this with you for hours, and I know we have in the past. But all I can say is it's so brilliant having people with your expertise and experience come into this space and be able to sort of act that bridging point between sort of big corporates and the industry, if you like, to understand how it can be part of a broader connected platform play and the use of camera. So yeah, I'm certainly excited too about what's coming, and just a huge thank you for joining us. Really appreciate it.
Total pleasure. Good to speak to you, Casper, as always.
Thanks. Cheers.